Hey guys, you guys have heard me talk about preparation for a while. I've talked about how you should gather food, how you should work on your food storage, work on your water storage, and acquire resources that you need to survive in case there's any type of emergency, whether it be an economic emergency, economic collapse, or whether it be a tornado, or whether it be a hurricane. You know, if there's one thing that Hurricane Katrina taught us is that, you know, you can't, your entire game plan can't be revolving around the United States government coming in to help you out, because I mean, if that's what you're anticipating, you may be setting yourself up for quite some disappointment. So a lot of this has to do with, yes, gathering the basic resources, but some of the things I like to do is spread out my resources, spread out the food, spread out the water. In my home, outside my home, it's never all in the same place. I believe in firearms. I believe in practicing as much as you can, even if you have limited funds. I also believe in storing ammunition, putting your ammunition in various parts of your house. One of the things you want to do is store your ammunition so that, say, if you have to go in a very short period of time, you would have a box grabbed and it has all the ammunition you would need. You don't want to be all over the place. I mean, you want to be somewhat organized. Now, for example, I have buckets throughout my house that has candles and has and each one has lighters, they have matches, they have headlamps and all kinds of flashlights throughout the house, and I know exactly where they're at. I have my knives, my utility knives. I also have a survival bag, which could be used for hunkering down, or could also be used for basically helping me go from one point to another point. It's all about organization. You can hide your stuff throughout your house. It's not that difficult. An old paint jar, an old paint can, you can put it in a box filled with clothes. Nobody's going to take the time to go through all that. You can also put it in an old TV, a CRT TV, say if you have some gold or silver, and put it in there. Or some plenty of areas you can put your stuff at. There's plenty of tactics you can use in hiding your stuff. Some people, you know, they'll actually go as far as like hiding stuff in actual floors or whatever, you know. You just have to look at your environment and see which areas will be best for you. I highly recommend people take this seriously, because people ask me, well, what if nothing happens? Well, okay. In order for that to happen, you have to go the rest of your life without any type of natural disaster, any type of emergency of any kind, any type of national event, anything. In order for you to be in a situation where it wouldn't even matter. Well, I mean, if you want to put yourself in a situation where you're just hoping that things always work out, it's, you know, that's up to you. But for those of you who are interested in doing something a little bit different, want to actually prepare for a possible challenge, this is one way to do it. You also want to get to know the people in your neighborhoods as well. See what they're up to. Just sort of share some ideas and see if there's some like-minded people in your area that you can actually talk to and actually share ideas, because you're not going to be able to do much of anything on your own. I'm quickly figuring it out on my own. I figured it out right now that you're going to need some help, or else you're going to be in dire straits. Because if you think you're gonna be on a solo mission like it's some damn 80s action movie, you're definitely mistaken. It's not gonna happen that way. So this really goes beyond politics. It just goes to like the core of what it is to be a human being. The focus on protecting your family. So regardless of your politics or your views or whatever, people are starting to see what's going on. I mean, somebody said that, well, I think that, you know, this is going to be like the lost decade of Japan, and, you know, Japan was worse. And I mean, come on, what's going on here is obviously a lot worse than what went on in Japan. We have a situation where we have like 43 million people on food stamps just last month. And you know it's going to increase after that. I mean, 43 million people on food stamps, tens of millions of people looking for work. We've had 9% or higher U3 unemployment for at least 18 or 19 months. That's never happened before. Some people say that, oh, well, in the 1980s, well, unemployment was higher. Yeah, for a shorter period of time. We've never had a situation where unemployment was above 9% for this long. We never had unemployment this high for this long, not since the Great Depression. So anybody who's thinking that, oh, well, everything's going to be all right, I'm sure things are going to turn around, you know, whether it does or not, you want to be prepared in case things don't really go the way you think they're going to go. And I definitely hope things get better. I could definitely benefit from things getting better, but that doesn't mean I'm going to put my head in the ground. So these are some things I hope you guys are thinking about. All right. Have a good day. And remember, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.